In this video, we're going to talk specifically about this post, which is one that excites me because it's the idea that we start collaborating together and sharing what is best practice to use within Google Classroom. So this activity is for you to explore additional apps and resources that Google has already said integrates directly with Google Classroom and to see which ones you might possibly want to use within your Google Classroom. Now, before I show you the page, and before we go and look at what you're going to do in this post, I want to remind you that anything that's added into Google Classroom should be discussed with your school administrator, district administrator, or district IT department. So make sure you have those discussions before you just try to integrate, but exploring and knowing what resources and apps do integrate already is a good practice, and it can hopefully help you think about ways to work with your students. So the first thing I want to do is let's go to the page. And this is created by Google for Education, which is a website that we recommend going to look for resources that directly work within Google Classroom. And you'll notice these are specific apps that integrate. You can refine by category, and you can also explore. So there's a few that I really appreciate. I'm going to click STEM just to look at this. So if I look at STEM apps, it's telling me these are apps that say they are STEM related. So GeoGebra, access tools for geometry and 3D graphing, along with over 1 million math games and lessons for students. So if I wanted to look more into this, this shows how to use GeoGebra directly within Google Classroom. So I'm going to go back. What about one of my favorites, which is Workbench? Workbench actually was purchased by Google. And this is an area to do project-based learning that already have lessons created for you that with one click will be added into your Google Classroom. Okay, so for example, let's look at characteristics of life, and these were created by teachers. And this tells us exactly what to do. Here's a video that you can add into Google Classroom. So there's Workbench. Now, we can continue on. So what about creative tools? Ed Puzzle, Explain Everything, Flat for Education. This allows you to compose and write music within Google Classroom and share it with your students. Great for music teachers. So your job with this task is to explore the apps that are available on this site and talk about which ones you might potentially want to use. If you have other apps and other resources you want to share, feel free to start that. In the next lesson, we'll continue the sharing and collaborating about what you do in classroom with your students and what you want to try. But the goal of this is to explore, have fun, because these are things that can impact teaching and make it valuable as you move forward. So what do you think? What apps will work with your classroom? Okay, looking forward to see what you post. Thank you.